Jody Vance with you. And if you don't already follow our next regular guest on Twitter, you're missing out on all of the factual information and scientific data that he brings to back it all up. Jason Tetreault has a way about him. He can take the extraordinarily complex and make it consumable for you and for me. Jason is the goods when it comes to addressing vaccine hesitant folks because he's not judgmental. He's there to just simply give you the answers you're looking for before you get the jab. I've been watching as one tweeter, if you will, tried really, really hard to poke Jason to goad him into a fight on social media. No go. The facts were flowing. It was so great to watch. So that sort of got us thinking, why don't we have that spill over onto your radio? We're looking for hesitant, for those who really need some scientific answers to the questions that you've heard through your circle of friends or that you've found online, wherever, whatever is making you hesitant about getting yourself immunized here in British Columbia. There are just a couple of things. There are a couple of rules here. You need to be respectful. You have to have a question. We're not looking for a rant. No, we don't 3-4 minute rants. No, we don't need that because we want to get as many people on the line as possible. So let's let the scientists talk too. You talk, Jason talks. I'll listen. 604-280-9898 is the number. 604-280-9898. *9898, a free call on your cell phone. He is super awesome. He is the host of the Super Awesome Science Show, and he is my friend Jason Tetreault on the line. Hello, Jason.
Hello there.
I'm super excited to do this because you are super awesome and nobody pushes your buttons. You are so steadfast in your responses and I love that. But before we dive in, because we got a bunch of buzz lines for you, because people love to call the buzz line when Jason Tetreault's on. Also, as I said, opening up phones 604-280-9898. But I want you to explain the difference between COVID-19 infection and COVID-19 disease.
Yeah. So COVID-19 infection actually isn't COVID-19. It is SARS-CoV-2 infection. And what that means is that the virus has gotten into you and it is just inside the what we call the epithelium. It's the outer layer of your skin and you have it both on the outside and on the inside in your nose and that. And it's multiplying and causing a number of viruses. Now, that's not affecting you per se, or it might actually hit, you know, like a goblet cell and start forming mucus and things like that. But for the most part, it's not going to cause you any major issues. Now, you can still spread that virus to other people, and that's one of the reasons why we need more people vaccinated. Now, disease means that the virus has somehow gotten inside of you and started to go into the lower layers, okay? And one of the best ways of knowing that you're starting to get the disease is you start losing your ability to taste and smell, because that tissue is very, very deep inside of your head. But if the virus can make it there, it'll start to actually turn off those cells and you'll lose the ability to taste and smell. And then, of course, if it starts going into your lower lungs, much like we see with very, very bad RSV, influenza, rhinovirus infection, well, then you've got a major serious problem. So infection, it's going to happen to absolutely everybody, regardless of your vaccination status. So get used to that. Yeah. Disease happens mainly in those who are unvaccinated, 3-5%, as we've heard you and Keith talk about it before, in terms of the vaccinated in British Columbia. And across the world, we're seeing it at around 12% for mild and 0.8% for severe.
The 0.8%. So that says real world data. How many people have been vaccinated now globally, ballpark?
My goodness, I think we're at 60% with at least one dose, something along those lines.
Yeah.
All I know is that right now in British Columbia, 1.72 million people have yet to be doubly or fully vaccinated, which is why we're seeing the numbers that we just heard about in the news update.
Okay, so let's get to some of these buzzline questions and then we're going to the phone lines. 604-280-9898, *9898 is a free call on your cell. We're looking for people who are vaccine hesitant, who need scientific facts and figures to answer what is concerning to you. Let's start with this first buzz line. This is a skeptic.
Hi, thank you for the chance to pose a question or two or three for Jason Tetreault at 4 p.m.
Sure.
I am an avid listener of CKNW 24/7 every day, except for when I sleep. I have not had a vaccine yet. I cannot because I have a medical condition. I have not heard a whole heck of a lot addressing the thousands upon thousands of us that do have pre-existing conditions that may be compromised by any of the vaccines. Mm-hmm. The vaccines have not been authorized by the FDA yet, which is a major go-to for a lot of us to have confidence, yet it's being mentioned today that Pfizer is trying to get some approval for the boosters.
Okay, that's part one of his question.
Yes, sir. So it's absolutely true. When you're doing those phase three clinical trials, you are essentially looking for individuals who make up the majority of the population. And yes, pregnant women, young children, people with pre-existing conditions such as autoimmunities, people who are on immune blockers, people undergoing cancer therapies, they're not going to be included. So therefore, they cannot be indicated or included in the indications. So I totally agree with you there. And what's happening is we're starting to learn through some of the real world data and other types of clinical testing, whether or not they can happen. But the beautiful thing is that you make up less than 15% of the population. So you may not even need to be vaccinated as long as everybody else does, because that gets us to the 85% herd immunity that we need. Now, in terms of the booster shots, we're still up in the air about that. We can get into that later.
Okay, the second half of his Buzzline question goes like this.
But what about all the garbage that's on the internet? Is it all garbage? We haven't heard too much of conventional media mentioning that maybe there are some opinions out there that might have credibility, considering that there are many, many people who have professions, who have degrees, who are coming out and they're saying that they have questions about the whole vaccine process themselves. We don't know what to believe. We need some leadership in media. We need people like Jason Tetreault to address these finite details that those of us who are intelligent enough to perceive, so we can make a decision as to whether or not we should get our vaccines without risking our lives. Thank you very much for your time. I'm waiting for an answer. Thank you. Bye.
What do you think?
100% agree. Yeah. Totally agree. The messaging throughout this entire pandemic has been horrid. I used to be part of the messaging group in Ottawa. I would be in Colonnade Road to help with PHAC and everything. I don't do that anymore. I wish I did, because we really do need that. And so I completely agree with that. And one of the things I've been joking about is there was this idea of Germ Guy Approved brought up about 7 or 8 years ago. And, you know, someone jokingly brought it up. I think we need to do that. So this message has been Germ Guy Approved. I think we really do need to do that in terms, considering, hey, we're going to election, right? I approve this message.
You should do that. I think you should do that, because you've written the book. You literally written the book. So you should do that, true. Jason. One more Buzzline before we get to phone calls. I see y'all lined up there. We are going to take live calls for sure. We're with Jason Tetreault all the way to the bottom of the hour. But I want to get to this one. This is a Buzzline question about the numbers.
Hey, Jody. Love the show. Hey, I just don't get it. I don't understand it, how these, with so many people vaccinated, how can the numbers just continue to keep rising? It doesn't make any sense to me. It tells me either that the vaccinations don't work as well as they say, because you would think the virus has nowhere to go, because there's only very few people that aren't vaccinated, but yet it can still go get out of control and get into the 700s. This doesn't make sense to me. Anyhow, that's my rant.
Yeah.
Anyhow,
it's a great question, though. Great question.
It is. And 1.72 million British Columbians are not yet fully vaccinated, and you need to be fully vaccinated to get to that 12%, 3-5% in British Columbia, or 0.8% of individuals who have breakthrough infections. That is why 700 is nothing. Sorry, I got to tell you that. You don't have enough people vaccinated, so you're going to see rises. You're going to see large amounts of numbers, and 5,000 active cases is nothing compared to 1.72 million. So get thyselves vaccinated, people.
Jody Vance with you alongside Jason Tetreault. Full phone board, ready to rock through these calls and questions. 604-280-9898. Let's go indeed. *9898 is a free call on your cell. Remember the only rules here: be respectful, have a question, no rants. We want to get to as many people as we can here. So have your question ready, and then let the scientists talk so we can get more information for those who are vaccine hesitant. Everybody on the phone line right now is going to help somebody listening, because these questions are great. The Buzzline questions were awesome. Let's begin with, is it Tony in Cloverdale? Tom.
Yes.
Tony in Cloverdale, welcome to the show. What's your question for Jason?
Hi. Well, a couple. I've heard the Delta variant is actually you just get a cold. I've heard it a couple times, and that they send you home. So I'm wondering that these cases, are they the Delta variant that people are being hospitalized, number one? Number two, they keep talking about more variants. In the beginning, they were saying that they suspect there could be variants where the vaccines don't work on them. Well, I haven't heard much more about that, and I don't really like the idea. Like, I don't take the flu shot because I believe in building your own natural immunity. I'm not sure.
Okay, stand by, Tony. Your question? We can't go into the deep thoughts about a flu shot. Let's get to those two questions, because I think they're very good ones. Jason?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, absolutely. So it is Delta. The reason that it is like a common cold is because people have been doubly vaccinated and therefore it's not affecting them as much, just like I said about at the top. In terms of the variants, the vaccines that we have here in Canada are actually taking care of all the variants, including Delta for the most part. And as a result of that, we're not seeing them and they're not really a big deal. So when you hear about Lambda, you can actually say, whatever. And then finally, when you talk about natural immunity, it's great. As long as you've seen the virus before, you haven't seen this virus before. So you can't say it's like the flu and building natural immunity. You are susceptible to death just like everybody else, unless you get vaccinated or you get a mild case of it.
Peter in Surrey, you're up next. Welcome to the show. What's your question for Jason Tetreault?
I'm a recovered person that had COVID. I read in my research from the Cleveland Clinic, rated number 2 in the USA behind Mayo Clinic.
I know people there, yeah.
52,000 people.
Okay, let's get your question, Peter. We got lots of people lined up here. What's your question, bud?
I have antibodies. My antibodies are in my bone marrow where they're supposed to be, not floating around in my major organs like my heart muscle. I wanted to get tested. Fraser Health.
Okay, Peter, I'm going to have to ask you to get to your question, buddy. We have literally 15 people
I know what his question is. His question is, why should I get vaccines? Because if I want antibodies, I should get them because I got recovered and they're in my bone marrow, as opposed to the antibodies that come from a vaccine. And the reality is that antibodies all come from the follicular germinal sites, regardless of whether you get it from a vaccine in your arm or you get it from an infection. And the reality is that the vaccine ones that you get are actually designed to be able to handle all the different variants. The one that you have as a result of recovering from a natural infection will only cover that particular lineage, and that another lineage can come in and actually not only infect you and make you sick, but possibly even make it worse. That is why the vaccine is so much far superior than a natural infection.
I hope that answered Peter's question. Honestly, I want to get to as many people as we can. 604-280-9898, star 9898. Christian in Pitt Meadows, welcome.
Hi there. Yeah, I'm just curious. We had developed a vaccine that's been really effective so far for adults. I'm just wondering why one hasn't been developed yet for kids under 12.
Yeah, actually, that's a really great question. As you know, kids are different from adults, and the same goes for the immune system. So the immune system from the age of 0 to about 12 is actually just developing. It's figuring itself out. And if you give it a wallop, like we do for anyone who gets the vaccines for adults, it may actually lead to significant side effects, much more than what we see in adults. So what they've done is they've reduced the dosage amount by 2/3, so that it's 30 micrograms for adults. It's going to be 10 for children, and they're testing that right now. But when you do that, as clinical trials go, you have to start from scratch, and that's exactly what they're doing. I hope to hear something by the end of September, so that we might be able to do it beginning of 2022. But again, if they miss out on the dose, they're going to have to start from scratch all over again.
All right, Sam in Coquitlam, you're up next. Your quick question for Jason Tetreault.
Hey, few people in Ontario and as well as Germany got injected with saline instead of the COVID-19 vaccine. Is there any particular reason why they have just the saline vials? And are you concerned at all about like a bigger portion of the population not actually receiving the COVID-19 vaccine and receiving that instead?
Yeah, I've never heard of that actually happening. There's a chain of custody that actually goes, and Providence is huge when it comes to vaccines, almost as much as restricted drugs. But if someone did end up getting saline instead of a vaccine, first off, nothing bad's going to happen. Saline is just what we have, but they really should be getting the vaccine.
I'm going to squeeze one more in, even though I'm risking it, because we have literally 1 minute. Bill, you got 30 seconds to ask your question. Bill in North Van, you're on the air.
Thanks. It's clear that you guys are regularly broadcasting false and conflicting information. Your guest is consistently...
Okay, Bill doesn't have a question. Okay, let's go to Alistair in Surrey with... thank you. Let's go, Alistair. You got the 30 seconds instead. Alistair in Surrey, did you have a question?
Yeah, but it'll take longer than 30 seconds.
Okay, I'm up against the clock. I got to get to news. So maybe send it to our Buzzline and we'll forward it to Jason Tetreault. He's great at replying, by the way. Thank you for your calls. All but the last one, who lied to Ryan Lehall, our producer, who is taking the calls from vaccine hesitant people, trying to make it an open dialogue. And Jason, you come at it in such a way that is so brilliant. I cannot thank you enough. That 30 minutes went by way too fast. Oh, I think we might have to do it again. Yeah.
We will definitely have to do it again. May I just say, the way that you handled them, you should be running the debates for this election. That's all I got to say.
Thank you. That is Jason Tetreault, super awesome science show host, good friend. Clearly, I will be paying him later for that nice compliment. You should follow him on social media. And if you have questions, he will answer you. When you @tweet Jason Tetreault or send him an email, he will reply with the facts for you. So glad to have you on here as a resource for us.